Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ's CAD class. Today we would like to build is this really common halo ring for engagement ring, and it's really popular. What we need to do is quite simple. We will need the following commands. First, we're going to use the revolve, and it will help to build the cup underneath the stone. Then we will use the pipe tool to make the prong. And once we make one set of the small stone, we'll use polar array. And I recommend you record a history so you can change the prong position. Finally, we'll use the sweep one command to make the ring shank. Let's get started. Before we start build our model, there are two videos I would like to invite you to take a look on it. It is on my YouTube channel at PJ Chain Design on the YouTube, and you will see this video is showing you a lot of terminology, how to set the stone, and tell you like what part is what stone and what is the proper way to hold the stone. And the other video is to how to build a diamond in Rhino 5. And this has two part on it. There's two video for how to build a diamond. And once you build a diamond, you can stretch it, make it into an oval shape if you like. So let's go back to the Rhino. First of all, we have a stone in our model. And in my case, mine is about 5.5 millimeter. Then we draw and we want to make a cup underneath it. So let me open another layer. Let's use this layer for the setting. So I will draw a square, and I want it to be longer than the cullet. And I'm going to move it here underneath the stone, but tilt it a little bit. So our cup will be tapered. One thing to pay attention, you don't want this in this position because you're gonna see a lot of metal and that will make your stone smaller. So we wanna roughly get it as close as possible. And if it is too long, we can always, you know, trim it later. So what I do is I'm going to use the revolve command and type it 0 as my center point, hold a shift and click on anywhere that will be 90 degrees, and then I want to revolve 360 degrees, so I get the cup there. Second, we need to make a prong, and we need to know where's the prong position here. So I'm using this curve, and my all snap is on, as you can see, snap on my endpoint. Let me light of front view, and I want to continue going up a little bit there. All right, so that will be my curve. Then I can pipe this one, and roughly about 0.8 millimeters, so radius will be 0.4 millimeter prong. It's really about the proportion. If you feel like this is a little bit too small, you can make it bigger. But the key is you don't want the prong to be overwhelming, because that will make the stone smaller. Okay, so now I need to move my prong just a little bit lower. In the right position. Okay, all I need to do now is to use the rotate and make sure copy equal yes on the command bar, and snap to the 0, and I wanted to have 4 prong, so 1, 2, 3, and 4. So I have 4 prong there. So we are done for the first one, and then we can rotate it like 45 degrees to be in the right position. Okay. Let's make a copy of center stone, Control C and Control V. Then we want to select everything beside one of the stone, and then we're going to hide it. So now we only have this stone. Okay. Let's scale it down to, on the top view, scale it down to roughly about 2 millimeters. And it really depends on your design. In my case, it's roughly 2 millimeters for this demonstration. And we're gonna do exactly the same thing we just did. So on the right view, I'm going to draw a rectangular, and it need to be longer to cut into inside of a ring. And then we're gonna use revolve this guy and do 360 degrees, and then so we have that cup. All right, gonna do the same thing. We are going to have we're going to draw a curve, a straight line, and I wanted this line to extend but follow the angle. So what I do is I move it back here, and then I hit the tab key, and then moving up you'll see a white line, and that way you will have a really straight line. And let's go ahead and pipe it. So 0.3 millimeter in radius, that's 0.6 millimeter in diameter. So that's one of it. And then we are going to using the rotate, and then I'm gonna have center is 0 and copy equal yes, and first is 120 and the second is 240, so I will have 3 prong evenly. Okay, and I'm going to again rotate. I'm going to move this guy down a little bit and turn on what we were hiding. So in this case, I need to have this guy rotate 180 degrees. And we want to get it as close as possible. And of course, we want to tilt the angle. It look more graceful in this way. And moving in a little bit. Okay, it look really nice. All we need to do now is to polar array the whole things. So I'm going to go to the top view and then go into a transform array polar, going to set the center to the 0 and guessing roughly about 12 of them. Just need to make sure that the stone is not touching stone like this. If it does, we might need to move the original one down a little bit. So let's do it again. We want to move it out a little bit. Okay, and this time let's record history. Go to transform array, polar array those objects. Center is 0, 12. So let's take a look on that. It's better. And I just noticed that I have double prong here. So in fact, we just need 2 prong instead of 3. So I want to show you this. So we want to go back and delete one of them. And we'll do the same thing like polar array. Oh, and then we want to make sure our history recorded history, and let's do the polar array. Select the object, and center is 0, 12 of them. And now I don't have a repeating prong. But if you take a look on the prong is kind of cutting it very like on both sides. So actually I need to have this prong moving up a little bit, so I'm gonna move this up because we have a record history, so every prong will move along with it. So now is it better? So we have all this ready. So what we can do is we can select all of them, and then we want to do bowling unit. It will tell you it will break the history, but it's okay because we no longer need history there, so we will have the whole things ready. Now it's time to make the ring shank. I just need a simple ring shank. So what I'm going to do is to draw a rectangular, turn on my old snap, and then again, this depends on the design. This tutorial, once again, is eyeballed. So I want to move the gumbo, and I want to use the move tool to move to the midpoint to the quad. And let me explore this guy. And did explore and did it one side. And I want to make this a little bit curved there. Alright. Then let me join them together and give them a little bit radius. Let's say 0.3. So they all look a little bit rounded. Okay. So I have one here, and I'm going to mirror to the other side. And on the top, all right, we need to make the stone a little bit lower. Okay, on the top, I need to have this profile going here. So I'm going to on the front view, and then I'm going to rotate it from the center. And you want to actually get into the model, so that way this you can bowling them together. But if you look at the perspective, it's a little bit too wide, and you can change it to make it the form is more interesting. So I'm going to make it more narrow so it will look taper. The same form is going to mirror to the other side, so it will be there. So let me just hide this temporary so you will see what I'm doing. So you see the line here, the curve here, and the curve there. Let me turn it into the red color so we'll see better. Alright. So what we need to do now is we are going to use the sweep. So sweep one. This is the rail and this is the cross section. Alright, and I like to keep them all in the inside of a ring shank and make sure they face the same direction. Alright, and we don't need to close the sweep. And now remember, this is on the surface, we need to cap this there, and you can type the command, so cap, and pick up your surface, and now they are cap. Okay, turn on what we were hiding. All we need to do now is to find our curve folder inside the ring shank. We go into the solid, extrude planar curve straight, and I want to make sure it's solid equal yes, both sides equal yes. Alright, then we need to do is bowling difference. The setting will be cut out by the tube. Remember, whatever you want to keep, click it first on the bowling difference. Then we just need to bowling unit those. But if you are going to have two tone, for example, this is going to be the yellow gold and the other one is white gold, and then you just keep them separately. Okay, for rendering purpose. All right, that's what we have for the hollow ring today. And I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in my other video. Thank you for watching.